signal and sound are on, the station goes on the air.
The sixth age shifts into the lean and slippered pantaloon, with spectacles on nose and pouch on side, his youthful hose well saved, a world too wide for his shrunk shank, and his big, manly voice turning again towards childish treble, pipes and whistles in his sound.
Radio licenses in 1950 reached their all-time high of nearly 12 million. And it was not easy to see where a new form of broadcasting might fit in. For most people, a television set in the 1940s and early 1950s was an expensive commodity. And television needed a really big event to establish itself in much the same way as radio had needed a big event, the general strike, to establish itself also in the public mood. Around 20 million people viewed the coronation service. For the first time, a new monarch was crowned literally in sight of all the people. It's interesting that at this time when television was coming into the picture in a new way, the radio itself was undergoing technological changes of a very important kind.
Now this changed the whole of radio. If I turn this set round, we can see that there are no valves there at all, but we can see three of these new transistors. And this made radio portable. It meant it could be personal again.
He says you'd like some jolly music to help you start the day, so what about this?
Keep our good day cleaners in
tonight, in practically every home in this country, this thing will be switched on.
Yeah.
And it will occupy, for most of the people, the evening hours. Anything to say about that at all?
It's a potential social menace of the first magnitude. Is that exaggeration?
Not in my eyes. Not in my eyes.
It's tingling fresh. It's fresh as ice. It's Gibbs SR toothpaste.
For 18 years, the BBC alone has provided our television. But from tonight, there will be an alternative and a competitor. And competition will bring its changes if it hasn't done so already.
There were, in fact, far more columns in next morning's newspapers about the death of Grace Archer than there had been at the opening night of independent television. Mary Crozier of the Manchester Guardian had this to say. She dwelt unseen amid the light among the Archer clan and breathed her last the very night that ITV began. She was well loved, and millions know that Grace has ceased to be. Now she's in her grave, but oh, she's scooped the ITV.